To commemorate the 30th anniversary of the dialogue relationship, the 2019 ASEAN Republic of Korea Commemorative Summit will take place in Busan, Korea from 25th to 26th of November. To promote dialogue partnerships between ASEAN and Korea, Ambassador for Public Diplomacy of South Korean Foreign Ministry, Mr. Chun Ji-bok, visited one of the ASEAN member countries, Myanmar, early this month. During his visit, the ambassador gave a lecture at Yangon University's International Relations Department on Shared Future, People's Center Community of Peace and Prosperity. Myanmar and South Korea has established the diplomatic relations in 1975. The two nations bear in mind the importance of promoting intergovernmental collaboration and also people-to-people exchange. Korea-Myanmar bilateral trade volume has exceeded $1 billion for the seventh consecutive year, and the two countries have formed a complementary relationship.
첫 번째로 이제 한국은 고등교육 역량 강화와 직업 교육 협력을 통해서 미얀마의 그런 우수한 인적 자원이 경제 성장을 이끌어 나가는 그런 주춧돌이 될 수 있도록 계속 협력해 나갈 것입니다.
Korea will enhance cooperation in the field of education, higher education and vocational education in Myanmar, as well as to set up in science and technology, technology capacity building and startup sector. The second one is the economic cooperation, focused on building up industrial zone, Korea-Myanmar friendship bridge and transmission network construction. Railway upgrading and new bridge construction. The third one is the cultural exchange program and people-to-people relations.
For cementing the existing friendly relations, President Moon Jae-in paid an official visit to Myanmar in September. During the visit, the two countries have signed a number of MOUs to strengthen connectivity and economic cooperation by establishing infrastructure and institutional foundation and promote diplomatic cooperation. His visits to Myanmar came together with the two other ASEAN member countries, Thailand and Laos, and it reflects his signature New Southern Policy. President Moon Jae-in announced New Southern Policy in 2017, and it is the Korea's new foreign policy that aims to strengthen its relations with ASEAN and India and to create people-centered community guided by the principles of 3P, people, prosperity, and peace. By completing a tour of ASEAN countries in September, President Moon has solidified the foundation to accelerate the implementation of the New Southern Policy.
The public diplomacy is to share the information about the Korean culture, their history, their knowledge. So one remarkable event is to know about the ASEAN-Korea relationship is very important. So this is also one of the President Moon's New Southern Policy, and that is why he visited our country together with all ASEAN member countries. He finalized his visit this year visiting the ASEAN member countries to show that and to commit his New Southern Policy.
ASEAN and Korea have maintained a high-level cooperation since the establishing a dialogue partnership in 1989.
30년을 기념하면서 한 아세안 이제 특별 정상회의가 이제 11월 말에 이제 부산에서 개최될 예정인데요.
To commemorate the 30th anniversary of the dialogue relationship, the 2019 ASEAN Republic of Korea Commemorative Summit will be held in Korea in November. Korea will discuss ASEAN-Korea future vision in the upcoming summit. President Moon visited Myanmar, Thailand and Laos to strengthen Korea-Mekong collaboration and release the Mekong vision. Korea government is also implementing the denuclearization and peace process on the Korean Peninsula.
The upcoming summit in Busan will play a crucial role in significantly advancing the relations between ASEAN and Korea. The first Mekong Republic of Korea summit is also scheduled to be held on 27 November.